Dear student, today we shall start another part of respiratory disease that is known as COPD, meaning by chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So this is not a single disease, it is a group of disorder that include 3, 4, 5 disorders like chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis, bronchial asthma, emphysema and bronchiolitis. So these 4 or 5 diseases are included under heading of COPD. The major cause is that all these diseases which is included in COPD has a common feature, and the common feature is that they are associated with the obstructive lesion in the respiratory passage. So although the etiopathogenesis, the clinical presentation, diagnosis and treatment are different for all disease, but the common feature is that they are associated with either partial or complete obstruction in the respiratory passage. So that is why it is known as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So we shall discuss the disease one by one in different classes. So first of all, we shall start chronic bronchitis. So let us try to define chronic bronchitis. Chronic bronchitis is as clear from the name that it suggests there is a chronic inflammatory involvement of bronchi. Literally, that means chronic bronchitis, that there is some inflammation, chronic inflammation in the bronchial part of respiratory passage. Pathologically, this definition is not important, or this definition has got some limitation, because in this condition, the inflammatory changes or inflammatory involvement of the bronchi is not so specific or so dominant. So we cannot say that chronic inflammatory involvement of bronchi is known as chronic bronchitis. So the chronic bronchitis is best defined clinically. Clinical definition hi zyadatar hum log dete hain chronic bronchitis ka, and this is defined in this way that there is persistent occurrence of cough with expectoration for at least 2 to 3 consecutive months in a year, for at least more than 2 years. So the usual presentation of this patient is that there is occurrence of or recurrent attack of cough with expectoration for at least 2 to 3 consecutive months in a year, for at least more than 2 years. So 2 saal se lagatar 2 se 3 maah tak कफ और एक्सपेक्टोरेशन का बार बार अटैक हो, तो इस कंडीशन को, इस प्रेजेंटेशन को हम लोग क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस कहते हैं. सो क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस इज बेस्ट डिफाइंड ऑन द क्लिनिकल ग्राउंड दैट देयर इज अ रिकरेंट अटैक ऑफ कफ विथ एक्सपेक्टोरेशन और एटलीस्ट मोर देन 2 to 3 एटलीस्ट 2 to 3 कंजिक्यूटिव मंथ इन ए ईयर. So this definition is commonly gives the clinical definition of chronic bronchitis. So chronic bronchitis can occurs most commonly in the middle age group of the people. Both male and female can be affected, but the most important cause of chronic bronchitis is smoking. So let us try to understand the etiopathogenesis of chronic bronchitis. Chronic bronchitis is mostly caused by the smoking. It has been seen that smoking causes more than 5 to 10 times occurrence of chronic bronchitis than a non-smoker. So this is the most common cause of chronic bronchitis. But question is that how this smoking play role in the development of chronic bronchitis. So persistent exposure of smoking for a long duration causes some important changes in the bronchi. The most important changes is that there is a hyperactivity of mucus secreting gland present in the mucus layer, submucous layer of bronchi. So the mucus secreting gland undergo due to the chronic irritation by the smoke undergo hyperplastic changes and hypertrophic changes, meaning by the number of mucus secreting gland is going to increase, the size of the glands is also going to increase. So that lead to the over secretion of mucus from the mucus secreting gland into the bronchial lumen. So these secretory material, mucus secretion, secretory material are going to accumulate in the lumen of the bronchi, and that causes obstructive changes, obstruction in the respiratory passage. And when there is obstruction, it's going to start. It is followed by the various kind of infection, followed by the inflammation of the bronchi, and that initiate the onset of chronic bronchitis. So this is the major phenomena, major changes that is going to happen due to the chronic exposure of smoking. Besides this, the another important action created by the smoke is that it inhibit the function of pulmonary macrophages. It also causes inhibition of the ciliary movement of the respiratory, present in the respiratory epithelium, that the cilia movement is going to inhibited because of chronic exposure by the smoke, and that inhibition of cilia lead to the persistent presence of secretory material in the lumen, and that causes obstructive changes. So besides this, it also causes a bronchoconstriction by the vagus stimulation. It also creates, because the secretory material are going to accumulate and that causes obstruction, it is followed by the infection by the different kind of bacteria. So that initiates the inflammation, and that is followed by the onset of chronic bronchitis. So in this way, the smoke play very important role in the development of chronic bronchitis by the different way. And they collectively causes the affected part of the bronchi undergo inflammation, and that initiate the chronic bronchitis in the form of obstruction in the respiratory passage. Another less important causes of chronic bronchitis is that air pollution. So exposure of air pollutant in the form of smoke or in the form of gas, various kind of gas, for long duration may lead to the initiation of chronic bronchitis. So people who are living in the highly polluted area, especially nowadays in Delhi, what is going to happen? They are more prone, more contact into the air pollution, smoke pollution, gas pollution, and that causes suffering of chronic bronchitis. Other causes like occupation, if the people who are working in the various kind of industry, that lead to the exposure of different kind of dust particle fiber, and that inhalation lead to the initiation of inflammatory changes in the bronchi, and that initiate the chronic bronchitis, especially those people who are working in the plastic factory or cotton factory. They are very much prone to contact with this dust particle, various kind of dust particle, and that are very prone to develop chronic bronchitis. Sometimes direct infection by the different bacteria, especially Streptococcus, Staphylococcus, Pneumococcus, that may cause infection followed by the inflammation, and that initiate the chronic bronchitis. Sometimes it has been seen, or it has a less important factor, that genetic predisposition or familial tendency can be seen in the chronic bronchitis, but it is not so important because it is not proved that the chronic bronchitis is associated with genetic changes or familial tendency or genetic predisposition. So this is not so important cause, but the most important cause is smoking, and followed by the air pollution or occupational history, that may lead to the अकरेंस ऑफ और कॉजिंग ऑफ क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस, बट स्मोकिंग इज द मेन कॉज. ओवरऑल ऑल COPD आर एसोसिएटेड विद स्मोकिंग. सो दिस इज द एटियोलॉजिकल फैक्टर दैट आर प्लेइंग डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस. द पैथोलॉजिकल चेंजेस, नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द चेंजेस दैट कैन बी सीन इन द अफेक्टेड पार्ट ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी पैसेज रेस्पिरेटरी सेगमेंट. ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट दिस डिजीज इज इन्वॉल्व मेनली द ब्रोंकियल पार्ट ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी पैसेज. सो ब्रोंकाई इज द साइट वेयर द क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस कैन बी सीन इन फुली डेवलप्ड स्टेज. सो ब्रोंकाई अफेक्टेड ब्रोंकाई इज ग्रॉसली इफ यू लुक द अफेक्टेड ब्रोंकाई इट इज मोर थिक एंड एडिमेटस एंड हाइपरेमिक बिकॉज ऑफ द सम हार्ट इन्फ्लामेशन. देयर मे बी चांस देयर इज द ल्यूमेन ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई आर फिल्ड विथ म्यूकस सिक्रेटिंग मटेरियल दैट लीड टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ म्यूकस प्लग इन द ल्यूमेन ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई. सो दैट कॉजेज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव चेंजेज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इन द ब्रोंकियल पार्ट ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. सो ल्यूमेन इज फिल्ड विथ म्यूकस प्लग. द वॉल इज थिक एंड एडिमेटस एंड हाइपरेमिक. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ चेंजेज कैन बी ग्रॉसली सीन इन द पेशेंट सफरिंग फ्रॉम क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस और इन द ब्रोंकियल पार्ट ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी पैसेज. इफ यू गो फॉर द माइक्रोस्कोपिक एग्जामिनेशन द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट दैट दे ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट स्मोकिंग इज द मेन कॉज ऑफ क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस एंड दे कॉजेज द हाइपरप्लासिया एंड हाइपरट्रॉफिक चेंजेज इन द म्यूकस सिक्रेटिंग ग्लैंड. So if you recall the normal histological pattern of bronchi that is there is lumen, it is followed by lining epithelium, followed by the mucosa, followed by the submucosa, followed by the smooth muscle layer, and lastly the outermost layer is cartilage. So the different kind of changes can be seen in the different layer of the affected bronchi. So first of all we shall see the what changes are going to occurs in different layer. As you know that the centrally the innermost part of the bronchi is lumen, and lumen is filled with the mucus plug because of the hyper secretion the secretory material mucus secretion from the mucus secreting gland present in the submucous layer which undergo hyperplastic and hypertrophic changes. So the lumen is filled with the secretory material. ल्यूमेन के बाद क्या है, इपिथीलियम है. ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट द नॉर्मली द ब्रोंकाई आर लाइंड बाय द टॉल कॉलोनर सिलिएटेड टॉल कॉलोनर इपिथीलियम. सो ड्यू टू द प्रोलॉन्ग एक्सपोजर ऑफ द स्मोकर और एनी टाइप ऑफ इरिटेशन फॉर लॉन्ग ड्यूरेशन देयर इज सम एडेप्टेटिव चेंजेज स्टार्ट इन द लाइनिंग इपिथीलियम ऑफ द अफेक्टेड ब्रोंकाई. सो there is the first changes is that there is a conversion of columnar epithelium into the squamous epithelium, and all of you know that conversion of one type of cell into another type of known as metaplasia. So there is a squamous type of metaplasia can be seen in the case of chronic bronchitis in the affected part of the bronchi. So this metaplastic changes if does not stop it can progress into the dysplastic changes, and that dysplastic changes again converted into the new plastic changes, that is the pre-malignant lesions for the bronchogenic carcinoma. So if the exposure of dust particle or air pollution or smoke is continued for long duration, if there is a long history of exposure, there may be chance of metaplastic or dysplastic changes in the lining epithelium, and that may lead to the development of bronchogenic carcinoma even in the later stages. So this is the changes that can be seen in the epithelium. The epithelium is followed by the mucus layer, submucous layer, and all of you know that this submucous layer contain the mucus secreting glands, plenty of mucus secreting gland which undergo hyperplasia and hypertrophic changes. So the hyperplastia and hypertrophic changes can be seen in the submucous layer, and the muscular layer is usually not affected because it is more distant and the inflammatory changes do not involve a muscular layer. So muscular error and the last the cartilage is okay, it is not so affected. So the different kind of changes can be seen in the different layer of the bronchi in case of chronic bronchitis. Sometimes because of the inflammation, although it is not so dominant, but due to the somewhat inflammation in the affected part of bronchi, there will be infiltration of chronic inflammatory cell, especially lymphocyte, macrophages and plasma cell in the different layer, especially mucosa and submucous layer, there will be the presence of this cell. And some because of chronic inflammation, so scarring and healing process is going to start. So peribronchial or bronchial fibrosis can be seen in the later stages. So these are the specific changes that can be seen in the different layer as the disease progresses. But one thing is very much remarkable here, that there is a quantitative assessment of these changes, and the changes that is noted by a index known as Reed index. So Reed index is nothing but it is a ratio of the submucous layer, that is the mucus secreting gland present in the submucous layer, the thickness of the mucus secreting gland present in the submucous layer to the thickness of whole bronchial wall. So एक Reed index एक ratio है, किसका ratio है, the thickness of the mucus secreting gland layer in the submucous layer along with what the whole thickness of bronchial wall. So this is known as Reed index, and Reed index is a quantitative measurement in case of chronic bronchitis, and it is going to increase in case of chronic bronchitis. So it is important for MCQ based examination that where in which condition Reed index is increased, so the answer will be chronic bronchitis. So this is the important changes, pathological gross changes as well as microscopic changes in the case of chronic bronchitis. Now come to the clinical presentation. So clinically, your patient is of middle age group, and most commonly the presentation is in the form of a persistent recurrent attack of cough with expectoration. That is the most important clinical presenting feature, and this attack is continuous for 2 to 3 months in a year, or from the last 2 to 3 years. This kind of presentation usually seen in case of patients suffering from chronic bronchitis. So cough with along with the expectoration, which may be mucoid or mucopurulent, this depends upon the bacterial infection present or not. So in case of infection, the secretory material or expectoration become mucopurulent. So this is the usual initial and most common presenting feature in case of chronic bronchitis. But as the disease progresses, different manifestation is going to start. So if the all you know that there is a hyper secretion of mucus secreting gland is seen in case of chronic bronchitis, which is the most important changes in the chronic bronchitis because of the hypertrophic and hyperplastic changes in the mucus secreting gland. So that causes obstruction, and when there is obstruction, that causes interference in the gaseous exchange. So your patient may suffer with the breathlessness. So पहले तो cough with expectoration होता है, लेकिन जैसे जैसे disease आगे बढ़ता है, जब mucus material block कर देता है respiratory passage को, तो your patient may suffer with breathlessness, and breathlessness may be at rest, that kind of presentation is seen. Sometime if the disease progress more in advanced stage, it is followed by the infection, bacterial infection, and that infection may cause a systemic manifestation in the form of fever, anorexia, weakness, weight loss, chest pain. So this type of feature can be seen. So different if in the more advanced stage, when there is a metaplastic or dysplastic changes start in the epithelium, that may cause the hemiptysis also, there is presence of blood in the mucous material. So this kind of presentation is an indication of somewhat changes, that is the neoplastic changes can be occurs, and that may lead to the hemiptysis. So different kind of presentation can be seen in a patient of suffering from chronic bronchitis. and all presentation or clinical presentation, all pathological changes that depends upon the severity, the duration of the disease and what amount of exposure to the air pollutant or smoke. This is the decide the different kind of changes and different kind of presentation in case of chronic bronchitis, because it is not this disease has got long progression, progressive disorder. It has got a long duration for the fully development. So as the duration increases and if your patient remain in the contact with the smoking or air pollution or industrial exposure, so there are different kind of changes will be seen as the time passes. And due to the different changes in the respiratory passage, in the different layer of the respiratory bronchi, and different kind of presentation will be shown. तो शुरू में अगर cough with expectoration होता है तो बाद में breathlessness आने लगता है, उसके बाद में systemic manifestation आने लगता है, उसके बाद में अगर ज़्यादा disease advance हो गया तो hemoptysis और का भी feature आने लगता है. तो all things depends upon the what type of changes is seen in the bronchi, and as the time passes various kind of manifestation will be seen. In the later on, COPD, especially chronic bronchitis, is associated with the core pulmonary, that it can involve the right side of the heart. So the right side of the heart undergo hypertrophy or failure. So if it is going to happen, your patient may again suffer with a different manifestation in the form of breathlessness on exertion, or there is edematous changes in the dependent part of the body. The jugular venous pressure, GVP, will be increased. So the all kind of the heart failure, all symptoms, sign of the heart failure will be seen in case of chronic bronchitis when it causes, when it involves the right side of the heart, especially in the form of poor pulmonary, that is the usual complication of a COPD, whole COPD. This is the usual complication in the form of poor pulmonary. So chronic bronchitis may lead to the poor pulmonary boom. Sometime another complication or another manifestation is going to seen, that destructive changes in the bronchi may involve the distal part of the bronchial segment, especially the sinus part where the alveolar wall is going to destroy because of the inflammatory changes, because of the infection, because of the extension of the chronic bronchitis from the distal part of the bronchi to involve the sinus, and as alveolar wall is undergo destruction and sinus is followed by the dilatation. So destructive and dilatation process will be seen in the distal part of the terminal bronchiole, especially in the sinus. So this lead to the development of another disease that is known as emphysema. So it has been seen that a patient suffering from chronic bronchitis, initially he is a patient of chronic bronchitis, but as the disease progresses, he may change into the patient of emphysema. So chronic bronchitis and emphysema is very much interrelated. They can coexist in the same patient because of their pathological progression of the disease. So chronic bronchitis, sometimes it is very very difficult to differentiate chronic bronchitis and emphysema because the presentation is very much similar. I mean, both conditions, there is a cough, there is expectoration, there is breathlessness, there is a respiratory symptom. So in both conditions, the presentation is similar. Even the etiology is same, that they are associated with a smoking, both disease, but there are some different also. So in chronic bronchitis, sometimes give confusion with the emphysema, because in the initial state, a patient of chronic bronchitis, if persists for long duration, he may convert it into a patient of emphysema. So there are different way for the differentiation of chronic bronchitis and emphysema that will be discussed in later on. But you must know that chronic bronchitis and emphysema can coexist, एक साथ भी हो सकता है. सो दीज आर द सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट अबाउट द क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ ए पेशेंट ऑफ क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस. एंड द मेन कॉम्प्लिकेशन इन द क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस इज दैट यूजुअली सिंस देयर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव लीजन इन द रेस्पिरेटरी पैसेज, सो दिट इज फॉलोड बाय द इन्फेक्शन. सो इन्फेक्शन इज द मेन कॉम्प्लिकेशन. देयर इज अ रिकरेंट अटैक ऑफ वेरियस काइंड ऑफ बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन, स्पेशली in case of chronic bronchitis, they are very much prone to infection because of the obstructive lesion in the respiratory passage. So a patient of chronic bronchitis may suffer with the recurrent attack of infection. This is the very common complication is seen. Sometimes there is more chance, there may be chance of malignant transformation because of the metaplastic and dysplastic changes. So there may be chance of development of bronchogenic carcinoma. Hemoptysis is the very important and dangerous complication that if it is going to seen in case of chronic bronchitis. And the major complication that there may be chance of development of emphysema in the patient, the distal part of the terminal bronchiole is going to be affected. Sometimes there may be chance of development of poor pulmonale, which is the usual complication is seen in the whole all COPD, and so chronic bronchitis is also associated with this type of complication, poor pulmonale. I think all of you know that what is poor pulmonale. That is involvement of the right side of the heart due to the disease in the lung parenchyma that may lead to the development of poor pulmonale. So poor pulmonale एक वो हालात है, वो condition है जिसमें right side of the heart is going to involve because of the disease or abnormality or pathology in the lung or in the respiratory system. तो लंग और ये रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम के सीओपीडी के चलते अगर हार्ट का इन्वॉल्वमेंट होता है तो इस कोरिलेशन को, इस एसोसिएशन को हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं, पोर पल्मोनेट. तो पोर पल्मोनेट इज वन ऑफ द मेजर कॉम्प्लिकेशन दैट कैन बी सीन इन द होल सीओपीडी, नॉट ओनली क्रोनिक ब्रोंकाइटिस बट ऑल सीओपीडी में भी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एज पोर पल्मोनेट. So these are the usual complications that can be seen in case of chronic bronchitis. A diagnosis is very easy because the clinical presentation is so important here, because chronic bronchitis is best defined clinically, clinical ground. So usual presenting feature, that is a cough with expectoration followed by the breathlessness, that is the usual presenting feature. And by noting this feature, if the duration is about 2 to 3 years, give the suspicion of chronic bronchitis. But if you examine the chest in the respiratory system, there is no specific finding will be seen in case of chronic bronchitis on respiratory examination, on inspection, palpation or percussion or auscultation of the chest. No specific finding will be seen. But if there is if some of the wheeze and bronchi can be heard in the auscultation. But the major diagnosis is made by the chest X-ray, and in the chest X-ray usually in patient of chronic bronchitis the chest X-ray appear normal, but as the disease progresses and if it causes core pulmonale, then the heart side will be increased, so there will be increased cardiac shadow and there will be dominancy or prominency of the pulmonary vessel in the chest X-ray. So this dominancy of pulmonary vessel in lung with the enlargement of the heart shadow is very important to differentiate chronic bronchitis from emphysema, because in case of emphysema the heart shadow become narrow. So this is the very important radiological difference between chronic bronchitis and emphysema to differentiate, because both condition presentation is very much similar. So on the basis of clinical history, on the basis of radiological finding, on the basis of respiratory chest examination, on the basis of other investigation like blood examination, and correlating all these findings, we are certainly able to diagnose a case of chronic bronchitis. So there is no problem in the diagnosis of chronic bronchitis. Since this disease is associated with the known causes like smoking, infection, air pollution or exposure of dust particles, so the disease can be prevented, controlled and treated also on the different way by the giving the mucolytics to expel out to liquefy the cough material so that the mucus respiratory passage become clear and the air gaseous exchange should maintain, so your patient may recover from the cough along with the breathlessness by giving the appropriate cough expectorant. Antibiotic is added because of there is more chance of infection, so a proper antibiotic should be given. In case of if there is any complication of the cardiac right side heart failure, then treatment is given according to this. So this treatment is very much successful because the disease is already diagnosed, their etiology is already known. So treatment is not so difficult for a case of chronic bronchitis. It is a curable, preventable, and controllable disease. So these are the something about chronic bronchitis. I think the concept should be clear for chronic bronchitis. In the next class, we shall discuss another COPD, that will be the emphysema, because chronic bronchitis and emphysema are very much interrelated. So we shall try to make a concept about the emphysema. We shall see that what are the points on which they are similar and what are the points on which they are differ. So by noting this similarity and dissimilarity, we can be able to diagnose as well as differentiate chronic bronchitis from emphysema. So the major presentation is that the cough along with the breathlessness, along with the other symptom, is the presenting feature in case of chronic bronchitis. It is, but in case of emphysema, the breathlessness is the major main initial finding. So there are many points on which we are able to differentiate. We shall see in the later on in the when we shall discuss emphysema in detail. So these are the something about chronic bronchitis, and in the next class we shall discuss emphysema. So till, thank you.